I know that you are like the quickest woman to do everything, and you can look amazing doing not much, actually. You're blessed
Thank
with
you.
genes. And Charlotte Ribeiro, who's our makeup artist on all our shows, has taught me a lot, and I research a lot, don't I?
Mm-hmm.
Bit obsessed.
And I have to say, I agree with you about the brows, because they frame the face.
Susanna.
And it's like, for me, I've got no makeup on.
Yep.
And if I did my brows, I would look so much better groomed. I'd love,
okay.
This looks like a sort of operating table.
I know,
table
I feel like
theater.
I'm going to surgically change you.
Okay.
But I'm going to do it, and these are all my little tricks here, okay? And they all do different things. But you can do a brow with a pencil,
mm-hmm.
or you can do a brow with a powder.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to do one with a powder, or one with a pencil.
Okay.
But the most important thing is you're a blonde, but you have dark roots. So I always feel you're...
And black eyebrows.
Well, I'm just going to get onto that. I was going to say, if you're blonde with a dark root, go the darkest bit of your root for your eyebrow. You have a model like Cara Delevingne right now who has these overly dark brows. They look incredible on her, but unfortunately we don't all look like Cara Delevingne, so it's quite a difficult look to carry off.
Yeah, because you can look like Groucho Marx.
You can, exactly. So if I chose a powder for you, I like Laura Mercier because they do two different colours, and you know how your sun, you know, in the sun your hair goes much, much lighter, then you might use a lighter colour. So you can mix them, and it's just like you feel like you've got a painter's palette.
The key, I much prefer powder to...
You do.
Pencils.
To
so
pencil.
I'm going to be interested to see
how
you do pencil.
Okay, so when I'm doing, I mean, you can see this is so manky. I'm embarrassed by this mankiness because I'm quite anal. But you get it. And I'm going to start with the lighter one. And then I'm just going to tap it. And I'm just going to slowly start in the place where you have less colour because you have a little bit here.
It's a bit
but you
see-through
have much
in places.
More see-through there. And it's
balding.
As much about
Sage.
Filling in the gaps as it is about anything else, all right? And slightly, you know, when we get older... your brow sort of goes down a bit and it can, you know, you will be, do you remember the show we did with ITV when it aged you? You'd be like that.
Is that the phone or the door?
No. Okay, so it's important to lift your arch a little bit and depending on the shape of your face to elongate or not. Now you've got a really broad face, so you don't need to elongate it. I've got a very tall face, so I will elongate my brow more. So it's more important.
You've got a broad face?
Yeah, you're because you're not long foreheaded, so your face is broader than mine.
Okay, compared, mine's more like that.
Exactly.
Sort of heart.
Like heart shape, and mine is more a very long oval. So when you have a long oval, you'll go much wider and you'll go straighter. And when you're heart shaped, you sort of follow a curve more, okay? So the colour here is working and it's slowly building up. I'm going to go a little bit using the darker one now.
On the outer bit, yeah?
On the outer bit, just to match up. And I've got to talk to you about plucking. I mean, plucking is another full conversation. And then what I love to finish off with is this. This is from Talika, and I use this. It's actually an eyebrow eyelash gel, and it's got a tiny bit of that product that darkens and lengthens your lashes, like Revita Lash and all those other products. But I use it every day, so before I go to bed, I do that and that and that and that. But what I'm going to use it for you is I'm just going to now brush your brows and bring to life the powder that I've used.
Okay, so it sort of liquefies the powder and makes
a
it
little
less,
bit,
less powdery.
Exactly, and also it takes away the Dennis Healy aspect of your eyebrow. But if you have a look now in that tiny mirror, can you see the difference?
Yes.
You can, good. I can see the difference.
No, I can definitely see the difference.
So on the other side...
It gives you strength, it gives your face power.
Well, it makes your eyes pop out. I see this eye now so much more than I see that eye, because that eye, I feel, is doing a bit of that, and this eye is lifted. So if you're ever going to use a pencil, really... So this is a dark blonde I'm using on you, okay? And it's a little bit dark, but the most important thing is never go, you know, with the line of your hair, go against it, because your hairs will stop it making that hard line that we see on so many women that we meet for makeovers, and we just want to rub it out, okay? I'm going to come around the other side, because I need to be perfectly positioned for this. Okay, so I'm going to go like this, start here, and I'm just going to go slowly towards the middle.
You know what? You really have taught me something. I never knew that about putting pencil on the opposite direction of the growth of hair.
Yeah, it's just... then you won't get the really hard line. You might hate it, but we'll see.
I'm sure I won't. So that is quicker to apply.
It is quicker, yeah. And I do use that sometimes more than I use the other one. It's a stronger defined brow. I think you might actually prefer it. Do I need a bigger mirror for your fuller face, darling?
No, you see, I feel like... I mean...
You feel it's too strong?
What's that? That's like a really old lady would do. It's kind of missed. You've missed it.
No, it's because actually, if I could pluck you now, you'd be fine. Okay? You really, Susanna, need a bit of plucking.
I know, I do. That's all going to be done.
This is because I got some of the gel on it. I could actually make that.
Can you see that really long hair?
Yeah, I can.
You know, I think the longest eyebrow hair I had ever had was about an inch long.
See, that actually has lifted... Stay there. I'm going to get the bigger mirror, okay?
I think...
Okay. Look.
No, I think...
You prefer the...
That is too
dark. Strong for you.
Yeah. Yeah. But it does. I mean, principally, it makes a huge difference.
What's interesting is if I take your hair down, okay, because now it's a softer look, because your hair's not straight back, then I think the darker one works.
Yeah, it does, actually. Can't you see the difference? It is amazing.
It's a huge difference.
It's amazing. What about your brows?
Okay.
Is there anything you do quickly?
No. Yes, actually, there is. Of all these products, and I could just spend hours on my brows, this one, Bobbi Brown, is amazing. I just discovered it last year, and it's an eyebrow gel. And, in fact, when we were doing our QVC, and there was a makeup artist who did our makeup one day, she had it.
Ah, okay.
And it comes in lots of different colours. This one, I think, is the light, dark brown or light brown, but there's four colours. One is a bit red for me, so you have to really find your right colour. But you literally, okay, go... on your brow, and you just put it like
so. That is like a mascara for the brow.
Yeah.
Brow mascara.
Yeah. I don't know why that. And I've got to say, I do like quite a dark brow.
That is so good.
But it's good, isn't it? And it's so quick. It's strong, and I'd usually use it if I did...
More heavier makeup.
Yeah, but I really... And also, it's doing both in one. So like my product that actually does your...
Fat.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a really good Bobbi Brown, great product.